This video is sponsored by this idea. At the hospital, can you explain what's been happening? I've been having sudden moments when I felt like I couldn't breathe, and I've been coughing up small pieces of what looked like flowers. Can you tell me what's happening to me? Well, I'm not sure, so do not take my word for it, but you're showing symptoms of a disease called Hanahaki. Do you like anyone? I do, but he hasn't shown any of possibly liking me back. What is Hanahaki? It's when you feel one-sided love. You grow flowers in your lungs, preferably their favorite flower or petals of their favorite color. It lasts for about 1 or 2 months and sometimes even a few weeks. If the feelings are not returned within those time periods, you suffocate from the flowers or petals. So you're saying, I could die at any moment? Possibly. This isn't the best news for anyone. So we are deeply sorry. I can't believe I'm gonna die young. At home. Hey, where have you been? Oh, I just took a walk for an hour. The breeze felt comforting. Yeah, okay, Sumu. Osamu and Atsumu went to their rooms. Atsumu locked his door behind him. What am I gonna do? I can't tell anyone about this, especially Omi. The next day at school, Atsumu sat in his class, not really paying attention to his teacher. He pushed his pencil back and forth until he let out a small cough. He looked at his hand and saw petals. Oh no, oh no, oh no, not now please. He felt more coughs on their way. He quickly covered his mouth with his jacket and asked to go to the bathroom. When the teacher said yes, he got up and rushed to the bathroom. He pushed the door open and stood over the trash can. Wave after wave of coughs brought wave after wave of baby blue flower petals. Baby blue, he told me his favorite color was yellow, and baby blue is my favorite color. No, that's just a coincidence. Baby blue is a popular, likable color, no connections to me. He coughed up more flower petals until he felt no more coughs. This is torture. He walked out of the bathroom and back to his class. The teacher asked if he was okay, and he said yeah. After school, Osamu and Atsumu were walking home. They talked until Atsumu felt like he had to cough. He frantically looked for a nearby bush and rushed over to it. He started coughing harder than he did at school. Osamu watched in concern as it sounded like Atsumu was coughing his stomach up. Sumu, are you okay? Atsumu coughed a few more times before coming up from the bush and looking at the baby blue petals. He walked back over to Osamu, and they kept walking home. Yeah, I just felt like I had to vomit, that's all. You know, you can tell me anything, right? I don't want to lie to him, but I have to. I don't want him to know. I know, Samu, I know. They got home, and Atsumu went to his room and locked the door again. People actually go through this. This is so painful. I feel my lungs slowly getting overtaken by petals. It's getting harder and harder to breathe. Atsumu coughed up more flower petals. These petals are so pretty. I just wish I wasn't coughing them up to see them. The next day, it's Saturday. Atsumu had been coughing day and night. Osamu being concerned, and Atsumu telling him he was fine, and it was just him not feeling well. Osamu didn't believe that one bit. He and Atsumu were downstairs. Atsumu in the living room and Osamu in the kitchen. Atsumu felt another dreaded cough coming and quickly got up. He ran to the kitchen because he forgot Osamu was there. He didn't have time to run somewhere else and coughed up petals right there on the floor. Osamu stared at the petals in shock, and Atsumu stared at Osamu with the same expression. Samu, why didn't you tell me? What? Sumu, why didn't you tell me? I just didn't want to worry you. Sumu, you could die at any moment. Why didn't you want me to worry about you? I just didn't, okay. I didn't want you to worry about me dropping dead at any moment from suffocation. It would hurt more If you didn't tell me you cold drop dead at any moment, imagine how I feel right now. You cold died at any moment and I wouldn't have known, and I would felt guilty, because I couldn't help you. Just imagine not being able to help your brother, when they needed it the most. The pain and guilt is unbearable. You can't do something like that. Atsumu felt guilty for not telling Osamu about what was happening. He's right. It would hurt him even more. If I didn't tell him, I'm sorry. I just couldn't tell you. I couldn't tell anyone. Sumu, you have to tell our friends. Fine. But I can't tell them. You can tell our friends. Just, please, don't tell Omi. You can tell anyone but Omi. Why? Atsumu looked at Osamu. No, Sumu. Atsumu nodded. I don't know, it's just something about him. So you like germaphobes, that don't like social contact with other people, and that plays volleyball. He doesn't even let you touch him. Hey, he lets me hug him sometimes. Yeah, for how long? I, like 8 seconds. Sumu.